everything in the universe you have to realize as Brahman, including me. In the process, me will get washed out. Okay? I cannot have separate identity. That separate identity from Brahman is giving me the problems in life, suffering in life. I don't want to be separate from Brahman. Neither the world is separate from Brahman. Everything is Brahman. Ultimately, God alone is the reality has to come. It's not that I am Brahman. I am not anything special. God alone is the reality, is the experience. That only is Mukti. Until you come to that point, even there is this little bit of separation. No, I am there and God is there. Okay, everything is God, but I am separate from that. You are in trouble. Okay, you have to lose your identity completely. Right? This is like a woman getting married. Okay, she leaves the parents' place and goes to husband's place. No, every day I go there. So then you are neither here nor there. You have to get settled in that place. You have to get settled in Brahman. Nothing else. No intermediate point. No point to stay in between. Okay, even if you are a little bit settled, stepping point is there, you are in trouble. Because the duality comes into picture. It will catch hold of you. Maya will catch you. You have to dissolve you in Brahman. I am Brahman also, nobody should say. Brahman only is there.
Brahman is there, not that I am Brahman.
No, I am Brahman is a starting point to understand it. But finally, I should go, I am should go, only Brahman. The world is there, finally Brahman, consciousness. So that much immersion has to happen. Okay, so then it's called Mukti. And now this you think, I'll do some 10 million years of practice, then it will happen. No. Even if you do 100,000 of years of practice, nothing will happen. Through jnana, clarity, and nididhyasa. Shravana, manana, nididhyasa. That's the only way. Okay.
We should be prayerful or we should be aware?
What is prayer?
Thinking of...
What is prayer?
Conscious.
What is prayer?
Prayer is thinking of God.
What is God? What is God?
Consciousness.
What is consciousness?
I.
So the moment you say God, the winged moon will bring the word for God, immediately the mind creates a split. The mind's nature is, it creates a split. Okay? The mind, even if a small opportunity gives, it creates a duality. And the duality will become big and go. So again and again you have to remember, everything you have to convert into I. It's not personal I, yeah. It's Brahman I. Okay? The moment you bring in some separation, it starts breaking. Ultimately convert everything to I. You don't use the word called Brahman. I. But that's not ego I. It's Brahman. So otherwise, if you start using some other word, some other place, it'll start getting deviated. The mind's nature is, it'll start creating illusions. Even I am Brahman, that I and Brahman is there.
Object subject
is there. That I has to drop. Then Brahman remains. Now what do you call the Brahman? As I. Right? And even if you are a little bit doubt that universe is real, then you will be never be able to come out of that. You have to get a very, very clear clarity that this is mithya. Anything is there with the reality of the universe, then you are stuck. You cannot go back to Brahman. You have to understand universe is unreal, mithya. Brahman is only reality. Brahman is my real I, not me, ego I. Brahman alone is reality. That much is dissolution has to happen. That is called Atmadarshana, that's called Brahmadarshana. And that will free you. And that's not difficult. Okay, that's very easy with a clarity. What is difficult in this whole process is, I want to get Atmadarshana, that desire has to come. That is very difficult. I want to get Atmadarshana, that desire will not come to anybody. Then I want to get Atmadarshana, then getting a guru is much more difficult. Okay? So if you get a guru who is able to teach clearly, because there are many gurus, they can't teach clearly. Okay? Ramana Maharshi is a great sage, saint, but he doesn't teach. Okay? He says, who am I? Look into that. He doesn't give any, he just gives a pointer. It doesn't give the depth. The teacher, getting a teacher is much more difficult. Then if you get a teacher, if you are fortunate enough to get a teacher and you understand it, that's all. But then these are all very difficult. It only can come through grace. Ishwara Krapa. Okay? It's not because of you. It's in spite of you. No, I did this punya, I came. No. There's somewhere Bhagavan, okay? There's a grace on these people, okay, go.
No, but that grace is there. Jnanadayam may come, put up its own.
That's what I'm saying. Jnanadayam also is a grace. That's what I'm saying. Okay. Out of its own, no.
No,
it
will not.
No. Ishvara doesn't violate any rules, okay? It is the rule of the Ishvara is Shravanam Mananam Nididhyasam must happen. That is the universal law. So grace, because of grace, Ishvara will forget some karma and do something. No. He'll follow the law of karma. He doesn't violate the law of karma.
But he'll see to it that you get that.
Okay? It is not that he'll do something randomly. The grace is not a random thing. Oh, think magic, some randomly something will happen. Like a politician, okay, he's my fellow, he's my friend. Oh, this guy is doing my puja 5 times a day. Not like that. Only thing is he'll make sure that you go in the right path. Need food.